Okay, I've just finished the bottom part of this leg. Now, as you can probably see, there's a slight ridge just along there, but it fades as it goes up along here. Now, if I turn this over, that ridge is actually caused by the top of the cutting blade. The top of the cutting blade. So what I've done is I actually want that ridge, and it continues all the way up the front of the leg, and also the back of the leg. That there needs to be cleaned up a little bit. But the reason it fades here is because this bit is actually the bottom of the cutting blade. So when I cut these, I do this side first. The top then creates this ridge. The bottom of the blade is smooth along here. Now, you'd be tempted to just roll it over, do the next one, and then do the next one and so on. But what I did is the part was going to be the front first, then I flip it over 180 degrees and do the back. That creates a ridge as well, so the front and the back, so the front down there and the back, both have these ridges on it. And then what will be the sides will just be smooth, and I'll just finish off the bottom individually. Okay, one of these legs has got a knot which has got a fairly large crack in it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to fill the crack with polyurethane. Let's get some of these loose bits out. First of all, I'm going to put a piece of wood underneath so that it's kind of level, because I want the polyurethane to soak into the hole and fill it. Now, I haven't got a syringe, so next best thing, I got this nozzle and it'll work like a syringe. Literally dip in, block, and just add it a little bit at a time. It doesn't matter too much about any overspill, because I can just sand it off anyway. That's well saturated into small crevices. While it's sticky, I'll push sawdust into the crack. This is nowhere near, this is not any sort of structural repair. This is just visual. The polyurethane inside the crack will cling to sawdust.